What is up, Measure friends? This is Eric from Measure School. I want to share a story with you that inspired this video. So I had a client that was facing several issues with their data in GA4. GA4 is a powerful tool, but like any other tool, it can have its limitations. To make things even worse, that client also didn't have access to the company's WordPress and couldn't find their GTM account. Some limitations of GA4. GA4 doesn't have a built-in feature to remove duplicate data. And even if you did, GA4 doesn't have retroactive capabilities, meaning any changes that you make will not apply to past data. So if you set up a new event, or set up a filter or conversion, these will only start working from the moment they were created and onwards, so you can't fix past mistakes. Lastly, GA4 is great at showing you results, but it's difficult to set targets to see your progress unless you know your numbers like the back of your hand. I'll show you exactly how I was able to overcome these in Looker Studio using just three simple yet powerful formulas. Because I know they can make a real difference for your business, I thought I'd just share them with you. Let's get started. Problem number one, removing query parameters. Why would you want to do that? Well, GA4 can sometimes look at one web page and report it as two pages if they have different parameters. For example, here I'm on the landing page report and you can see that this page brings in close to 7,000 sessions and close to 6,000 users. And the second page, 4,000 sessions and close to 4,000 users as well, and so on and so forth. The issue with this is that all these pages are actually the same page. For example, if you share a link on Facebook and you got multiple users clicking on the link and landing to the page, for each of these users, Facebook will add to the URL a unique parameter, which will generate this duplicated data in GA4. The second issue now with all these duplicates is that you may not know, but GA4 has a number of limited rows that it can store, which creates a problem known as high cardinality. Hence the reason why some of you may have seen this weird entry called other. And this is problematic as you can see because the other takes quite a large portion of our data. Now, you can fix this in GA4 by using explorations, but if you have a larger website, you'll be exposed to sampling issues. Let's see how to fix this in Looker Studio. So I'm now in Looker Studio where I have added the landing page dimension which has the query parameters to a chart table. Now here I can click on specific links to see how those pages are basically trending over time. Now the issue with this is that some of these pages are actually the same page. For example, here you may be under the impression that we have so many different pages for our jeans category, but in truth, they are all the same page. Same for our blog page category. These are not different pages, these are all the same page. To fix this, we'll use a formula using regular expressions. To build a formula in GA4, we need to create first what is known as a calculated field. And there are two ways to do this, one is at the chart level and the other one at the data source level. I'll use the data source level. So click on data and then go to your data source and within your data source, look for add a field. Now I'll add a field, and here we'll start building our formula. Name your field. We'll use a regular expression, so I'll start writing regex and select regex replace. Now add in your dimension, the dimension that you want to tackle. In our case is the landing page dimension. Select the right dimension. Add a comma, and don't worry, I'll explain what all this means. Just follow along. Brackets, and then... So, here, we're basically saying, grab everything that comes after the question mark. And what starts with our question mark? The query parameters. So here, we're basically grabbing all our query parameters. All right, let's continue. Now, what do we want to replace our query parameters with? Well, with nothing, because we want to have them removed. So I'll just put my brackets and write nothing inside. Now, if you see the green check mark, this means that the syntax is valid. Let's click save and then done. Wait a second, and here you should see your calculated field. Now select your chart, and what we'll do now, we're gonna grab our calculated field and bring it to the chart. Perfect. So now I'll just readjust this a little, and here it is. Now you may notice that we have removed our query parameters, they're not there anymore. But the issue is that we still have duplicate data, and this is because we have kept the landing page dimension. So let's edit this again. I'll remove the landing page dimension. And voila, we're now left with our accurate numbers. Here is the home page, and here is the genes category, and here's our page with our blog category page. Problem number 2, untracked data. Here they needed to track their blog content categories to know how their content themes performed. So let's say that you have a blog about animals and write articles about cats, dogs, and birds. Without access to WordPress or GTM, how do you extract these topics from 100 and plus pages and place them into different categories, also known as content groups, for analysis? Now, you can create content groups in GA4, like for example here, you can see that you have actually the content group primary dimension, but in order to do this, you'll have to either mess with the Google tag code or send custom parameters via Tag Manager, which the client didn't have access to, or use Firebase. We can achieve this quickly in Worker Studio with the help of the famous case formula based on the page titles to create groups of topics, like you can see here. There you go. And by the way, this solution is also very useful if you want to track product categories for sites that don't have e-commerce implemented. Let's see how. We have our table here with our page titles. Now let's build our formula. I already have it named, so we're just gonna modify this and start from scratch. So we'll be using what is known as a case function. The case function basically allows you to create a condition that returns a value if true. This is as if you're saying, if this is true, then do that. So simply type case, and don't worry, I'll explain everything, just follow along. Then when, and we'll bring back some regex magic. So type regex, and select regex contains, and then here we'll add the dimension, which in our case is page title, and then here I'll put a comma, brackets, Google Analytics 4, and then a pipe operator, which means or, and then GA4. Then brackets GA4. All right, so let me explain to you what am I doing here. So our blog has a lot of content around Google Analytics 4, also known as GA4. So some posts may have a title like how to learn Google Analytics 4. Another post can be how to track forms in GA4. One content theme, but different wordings. And we can add them as different conditions in our regex. So basically what this means is if any of our page title has the words Google Analytics 4 or GA4, then create the GA4 content group. Now, I'm not gonna show you all the steps for all the other ones, but I'll just paste all the other ones. So here you can see all our other content groups for ads. We have one for BigQuery, one for Tag Manager, and definitely one for Looker Studio. Make sure to end your formula with else. And here it can be anything. You can put other, darkness, or unknown, anything you want. And end with end. All right, so let's update this. Now what you'll do, we will just add in our calculated field to replace the dimension here. So I'll just replace the page title with it. And here you go. We have now our content groups. And then this is very useful because you can analyze your other content groups. For example, here we can see which content group brings in the most users in terms of traffic, or brings in the most engagements, or the most conversions. And this is very insightful because here in this example, we can see that we have a content group, the one that we call unknown, which are the ones that we didn't really categorize. And this indicates that there may be other contents that we can explore to find new topics. We can see also that a lot of these unknown topics brings in the most conversions. Number 3, progress tracking. With all the features GA4 has, it doesn't help you much when it comes to setting targets and knowing how you're progressing towards them. For example, here they wanted to track their efforts towards reaching 12,000 users for the month of September. Here on the right side, as you can see, we have the goal that they have, which was 12,000 users, and here on the right side is the actual number that they hit, 92%, which is pretty impressive for the whole month. The other good thing with this is that you can also track your progress as you go along. So let's pretend that we started during the 1st of September and today was the 10th, and we wanted to track how far we have reached. Now let's see how to achieve this in Looker Studio. So we'll just edit. And I'll just remove chart. So basically here I have shapes. This is text. This is just text and text, except for this, which is our actual number of total users, as you can see here with the total users metric. Now let's add our calculation. Add a field. Let's name it a bit differently. And let's build our calculation. And by the way, I got this simple yet useful calculation tip from Egan Heath from Get Found Madison, and I just added a few tweaks and changes with the charts. Let's put your total users, and divide it by 12,000, which is the goal that we've set. All right, now click save, then done. Head over to your charts and let's add a chart, and we'll add the Gao chart without the ranges. You can also use the bullet chart, paste it right here. Now let's go find our metric, which was we reach. There you go. Here's our calculation. You can just add it in the chart. I'll increase also the font size. Let's go for maybe 36. Increase again, 38. Perfect. Now you may notice this number, which looks quite off. And this is because we have our metric as a sum and we want it as a percentage. So go to the pencil icon, then go to number, numeric, then percent. And here's our accurate number. Now, right click, duplicate, let's drag it down here, and let's stretch this out. And we'll change this chart style to add a time series chart. And there you go. Congratulations on making it to the end of this video with me. Looker Studio offers a lot of formulas that can help you find solutions, but these three can be applied to a wide range of challenges. I hope you find some useful ideas from this video, and if you have any questions, please don't hesitate to ask us, because it helps us to understand how we can help you better in the future. In any case, thank you for watching. This was Eric from Measure School, and see you next time.